I don't think we are having these conversations if Michael Jordan didn't do what he did on the basketball court. It kind of like lives and dies by how good he was. And because he was extremely good and because he was winning all of these championships that kind of correlated and kind of related to the shoes that he was wearing, that's why we are talking about this brand now. And that's why it's so important. It doesn't work, you know, if he's not doing those things on the basketball court. You know, the whole kind of scope of Nike's marketing was, you know, is it the shoes? Like, you know, is he doing these incredible things because of the shoes that he's wearing? You know, so if he's not very good, then it's not going to be the shoes, is it? And you wouldn't want to make that connection. So yeah, I think it all lives and dies by how good he was on the court. In relation to Spike, I think you could argue that, you know, the brand was built off of his back as well. You know, if you think about those early Spike and Mike adverts, they were revolutionary. We'd never seen, you know, adverts like that. They had humor, they had personality, they had, you know, pace, they were engaging, and they were pretty hilarious for the time. So, I would argue that he plays a central role in all of this. And also the fact that, you know, his early work was so central to sort of like placing the Air Jordan in it. She's Gotta Have It, Do the Right Thing. The Air Jordan is central in those films. So yeah, I would argue that Spike's pretty important.